Calm down, Mike.
Okay. God.
My bad, my bad.
If you're just joining us, this is Couch Dwellers. We've got a new trailer today. It's special. It's near and dear to me and Mike's heart.
Yes.
We're huge Tarantino fans.
Quentin Tarantino, that's just exactly in case right, yeah. They were thinking of Bobby Tarantino. which is Logic's alias, right?
Well, we got this new trailer. They had a teaser, but we got this new trailer now, it just released today, for
Once Upon a Time.
Come on, man. You're his biggest fan. He's not even here and you're locking up on him.
Look, we've been here. Ryan and I missed the release, the Christmas release roadshow of The Hateful Eight.
Yes.
And we've been pining over it ever since. Yep. And we were like, next film that he releases, it doesn't matter what time, we're going out, we're seeing it. And sure enough, here we go, the ninth film by Quentin Tarantino, Once Upon a Time in Hollywood. Let's watch the trailer, then we'll talk about it.
Oh, yeah.
I'm Rick Dalton. It's my pleasure, Mr. Schwartz.
Call me Marvin. Put it there. That's your son?
That's my stunt double, Cliff Booth.
Last night, we watched a Rick Dalton double feature. All the shooting.
Yeah, Al Pacino, baby.
I love that stuff, you know, the killing.
A lot of killing.
Is this the first time Pacino's been in a...
Yeah. My God. Seems this
world got you down. Yeah. He's so good, man.
No, I'm a stuntman.
Already.
Yeah. So hey, check it out. His shirt's up.
Still here.
You can do anything you want to him.
My God, this cast, dude.
I hired you to be an actor, Rick. Not a TV cowboy. You're better than that.
Line. Cut! You embarrass yourself like that in front of all those goddamn people.
All right, what's the matter, partner?
It's official, old buddy. Well, it has been.
God.
Here I am, flat on my ass. Who I got living next door to me?
I'm Sharon Tate.
Sharon Tate.
I'm in the
Tate.
Movie.
You're in this?
That's me. I play Miss Carlson, the Klutz.
Oh. Charlie's gonna dig you. And that gospel
man. Man.
Dakota Fanning,
right?
That can all change like that.
Hey! You're Rick fucking Dalton. Don't you forget it.
Man.
God, you know a trailer's good when it just shuts you the fuck up.
Well, that's the thing is I started talking, I was like, I'm missing stuff.
That was stellar, man. This feels very, kind of feels Pulp Fiction-y for some reason.
I think that's what a lot of people were saying.
Man, I'm blown away, man.
I'm kind of speechless on this one just because I've purposefully not done any sort of looking into it. I want to be completely shocked and surprised. I want the full roller coaster, you know?
Yeah.
And so, I mean, I don't want to read anything about it. I just want to experience it. And I think so. I don't really have a lot to offer other than I'm as excited as one can be about seeing this movie.
Oh, it looks amazing. I think it's July 26th, we found out.
Yeah, that's what you're saying, yeah.
This looks incredible.
I thought I was having to wait till the end of the year. It originally had like a September release date.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh man, but I think he pushed it up. From what I was reading, he pushed it up to show it at the Cannes Film Festival because of the anniversary of Pulp Fiction, which was shown
Oh, well, then now it definitely makes sense why it kind of has that vibe to it.
Yeah, yeah, totally. So this is, I mean, Tarantino says he's only given us 10 films written and directed by Tarantino, and I know these last two have to count.
Oh, they're going to be amazing.
Not that the previous ones, I mean, other than by his own definition of Death Proof being a flop.
Yeah.
Well, he didn't like it. It was his least favorite, but he has an amazing catalog. Yeah, I mean, if you like Tarantino, you can watch any Tarantino film and love it.
Yeah.
You know?
I'm trying to think. So Death Proof came out, that was after the Kill Bill series, right? I believe. Then it was
In like 2006, 2007, something like that it came out.
And then after that he did Inglourious Basterds?
Yes.
Then it would have been
Django and then Hateful Eight. Yeah.
So he's really kind of been in like some kind of niche genres recently.
Right,
you know, with
the spaghetti western type.
Yeah, even the Inglourious Basterds, kind of a spaghetti western in a sense.
Yeah, yeah, like a modern day.
Yeah, so now this is kind of going back to what kind of made him him, which was, I mean, not that those are bad, don't get me wrong, but this kind of has the feel of like Pulp Fiction, God bless, Jackie Brown,
right?
Kind of like those kind of stories and stuff like that. It's more modern. Well, of course, it's 1969, but still, sure. It's pretty close to what we're now. But man, I really have a good feeling about this movie, man.
The one thing, and he has an amazing list of actors, but the one thing that Tarantino does, I think, better than anyone is the storytelling and character development. And every single character has such a rich history.
Yep.
You know what I mean? And so I'm so excited because there are huge, I mean, with Manson and Sharon Tate and all that stuff that was going on, like the Manson family murders and stuff, like that's just a cliff note, or a footnote or whatever to the story he's telling of DiCaprio and Brad Pitt, right? Like from their perspective. So with these things, to have some really juicy meat like that, and that not even be the main story point, it's going to be so good, man.
I have no doubt this is going to be amazing. I did not know Al Pacino was going to be in this. I think that's going to be a stellar addition to this.
Who was supposed to be in it but passed away?
Man, I can't think.
I can't remember who it was. Burt Reynolds.
Oh,
Burt Reynolds was
supposed
to be
in it.
And maybe Al Pacino is the one that's replacing him.
Interesting.
Yeah.
I think Al Pacino is a great selection for this. And man, you got him, Kurt Russell, Brad Pitt, Leonardo DiCaprio.
Yeah. Yep.
I mean, this list is huge. And like you said, he's going to make every character. They're always kind of, every character kind of has, they're kind of a badass in their sense.
Right.
Know, who they are and stuff, so.
I feel like you could take any one character of a Tarantino movie and strip away the rest of the story and it would be sufficient. But he packs so much into, just like with Hateful Eight, like you've got the Hangman.
Yeah.
That could just be one story right there, but then you have the backstory of Samuel Jackson's character, then you have all the stories of the gang and what's her, Jennifer Jason Leigh's character. Like there's so much going on in that movie. It's probably one of my favorite Tarantino movies because it's so rich in story.
Yeah.
Not that all of his movies aren't.
Oh yeah.
But man, he does such a great job. I'm blown away that he can write such dialogue and the great scenes and all that and then turn around and film it.
Yeah.
And direct it.
Yeah.
You know?
Like I said, he gets the most out of everybody.
Yeah.
You know, kind of like, I mean, this isn't even a comparison, but, you know, prime Kevin Smith, that's what he could do with in his movies. He got the most out of his characters. Their dialogue was always fun to listen to. And that's what Tarantino does. I'm always just entrenched in listening to every single detail in a film of his just because everything's so well done.
And he also does that thing, too, where if he really wants an actor but can't afford him, like he takes a pay cut to make sure the story's done right, you know?
Yeah.
And a lot of times he writes these characters with an actor in mind.
Yeah.
You know? So we could go on for hours about about Tarantino and about his movies, and I think this is why we were giving Spider-Man such a hard time, and really the superhero movies that are like the cotton candy, like it's, you know, it's, it doesn't have like the meat and the story behind it. It's just kind of based off of, you know, so and so is a superhero and he's fighting this villain, and then oh, they have a love interest, you know, yeah. And that's like the gist of it. But
just eating popcorn.
That's it. Yeah, and that's fun to do too.
Yeah.
But movies that I appreciate and want to keep going back and keep watching and talking about, it's definitely made by guys like Tarantino. So I know we're both just crazy excited to see this. I'm so glad it's coming out in a couple of months.
And we're not going to f*** it up this time. We're
going
to go see
theaters. Yeah, yeah. We got to go the night it releases,
man. It's going to be sick, man. I'm really stoked for it. So for me, this is an obvious, I'm watching this thing.
Yep.
For sure.
100%.
I'll be shocked if it's not good. So I'm really looking forward to this. I have a good feeling this is going to just be, it's going to be a classic.
It'll be one that people will talk about for years.
And I have a feeling that, I know they're going to show the Sharon Tate murder. You know it's going to be Tarantino-esque. It's going to be
brutal.
It's going to be graphic. And he's going to know how to show it right, you know.
And he'll add that sort of dimension, like the horror and the like grotesqueness of it, and he'll couple it with really funny points, really like dark, sincere moments. He's good about giving the audience so much, like different emotions all in one movie. And I think that's why he's not really focusing on just the Manson stuff, because that's the thing, is all of his movies have like a spectrum, like a wide spectrum of different emotions that you go through. He gives you moments to laugh at. He gives you cringy moments. He gives you, you know, like scary moments and action-packed moments. You know, all the movies that he does, he's so great about adding in. It's an experience. It's like a roller coaster ride, you know, and that's what it should be. It shouldn't be a predictable formula that works for summer blockbusters. It should be something that takes you on a journey that you learn a little bit more about yourself by the time you finish it. You know what I mean?
Yeah. And one last thing. Whoever the guy is that got to play Bruce Lee looks like his damn twin. Like, I'm really excited. I remember in the teaser, they didn't show up here, but in the teaser, I feel like he's going to be huge comic relief in this movie.
Yeah.
They made him really over the top. Really close to what Bruce Lee was, but just enough to make it funny enough with him. So, but again, I'm ready to watch it. Let's go watch it.
Let's go watch it. All right. Well, thanks for joining us. Again, we want to thank our new intern, Todd, for helping us out with this.
Thanks, Todd.
Be sure to edit out anything that Ryan said and make it clean, soapy and sweet for the audience.
And make sure people, you know, Todd, he is interning. He doesn't get paid a lot.
He doesn't get paid anything.
So leave him a comment. Say something nice to him.
That's right. Look, even if you don't like us, like and subscribe for Todd, please.
Yeah.
Just do it for Todd. Okay?
Just subscribe for Todd. Okay?
Hashtag do it for Todd. All right.
That's it for us.
Yeah. Like, subscribe, ring the bell. And as always, you're welcome on the couch.